Oysters, did I hear you say? No, not yet. Not today. It is still too soon for oysters. I am putting a little of my pension aside each week. When I have enough, we will have the oysters. And not tin ones. Fresh. Still smelling. We shall take them alive, slip them slimy onto our furry tongues, turn them slowly, feel them jerk and twitch and gasp as they come sliding down our swallowing throats. Yes, all right, I know. But think of it as a sort of Eucharist. raw vegetables, don't you? Haven't you heard those recordings that made of vegetables screaming as they're pulled up? You eat fruits, don't you? And they're still alive. The French call oysters fruits of the sea. And they know more about food than any other nation, except perhaps the Chinese. And they eat sea slugs, don't they? 100-year-old eels. Monkey brains, which they say must be served hot and steaming. Nothing like that tonight, I'm afraid. Fish fingers. I do have an old slice of steak and kidney pie. A bit stale, but it still has most of the kidneys. I always keep the kidneys to last. They are velvety, mauve, like immature beetles.
Yes, all right, I know. Our relationship is beyond analysis. I prefer to name no name, but I know you've been listening to Vernon, who says it has a Boy Scout flavor to it. So much he knows, Vernon, who travels halfway across London to find the one priest who will forgive his sins.
Still too young to understand that in such matters, it's the expectation which is everything. The anticipation which makes things worth. Good conversation is like building ideas like guard houses until one gets dizzy and trembles about. That takes experience, stretching the expectation, extending the anticipation, postponing the climax. Things have got to happen eventually. Not yet. Never yet.
I'm a man who can make a lump of barley sugar last all day.
It's like these sheets here. You've got to know exactly the right time to change them. Do it too soon and you never get that lovely, musty smell.
But if you leave it too long, you can't sleep for the stench.
Dishes to washing. There's nothing quite like that thick, sticky texture of congealed grease and a dirty, cracked dinner plate. But if you leave it too long, it just gets hard and loses its smell and is simply useless to scrape off. I keep the dishes to attract like honey. I know some people say what you're always trying to live in the present, in the here and now, but to me it's the future which makes it all worthwhile. So long, of course, as it doesn't ever. I don't know. I don't know that. That is still to come. Many episodes later, I shall record it if and when it is revealed. I must admit that I love that. I prefer the last one. Pretty. Something a little more feminine. When I finally take it to bed, I shall get a better idea of the truth. But I don't escape, so to speak. Did you get the part? She's too sharp. Eats tacos. Meg little runs. Thank you. And how is your situation today?
The employment market is still not at its best just now. Vacancies in biotechnological cloning, Korean language instruction, serial killer profiling research. I'm keeping my options open. And how is your situation?
I went to see George on Sunday. I come every third Sunday to see the child.
I have told you 100 times how unreasonable this is. Would you like to hear a joke? Perhaps you've heard it before.
They never put them in. Don't you think they should put them in?
What?
Babies. Aborted babies. They're unlisted. Do you think that they have souls?
I have never thought of the matter.
Don't be half.
I am not happy.
Do you like bath sugar?
What?
If I had a piece, I'd give it to you. It's a very special art, sucking barley sugar. The patience to make it last. The discipline required to forget the teeth use only the tongue.
I am old. Soon I will die. It would be nice to make things last.
I'm so morbid.
I've never told you what I do.
No.
I help do abortions. We all have our jobs to do, should we be so lucky as to have a job, which, as you know, I don't.
The abortionist is not a doctor.
There are various rooms around London, sometimes Notting Hill, Shepherd's Bush, There's one in Wimbledon. A large house.
Do you wear rubber gloves?
I've always thought that they must have soles. When's she? The woman that I work for. When she does it, there's a noise like cutting a pear. But a lot now. I've helped to kill more people than live in this street. I counted the houses in the street one night. I worked it out.
It's not such a large street. Important. Not very large.
Twice as many as in this street.
But still it's not so many. And we have a problem with population. It's like contraception. Excuse the term, apply to little Baker. She's going too fast, isn't she? Jobs, that's all right. We can talk about jobs at the stage and the people she likes, where she was born, that sort of thing. But really, it's much too soon to be discussing ideas for the souls of aborted babies. It's all coming too fast. Like a rebel in a sweater. It would be nice to make things last. You are morbid. Smell? What do you smell?
Washing up.
It's an antiseptic. I feel I've become soaked in antiseptic to the marrow of my bones. It has come to upset me.
It would be better if we ceased this conversation for a while and had something. Talk about the food. I have fish fingers again. I've never told you this. But the fish fingers always tasted antiseptic. Everything.
You should have told me that later. That's with the rest.
It's good that you didn't say it. She was
She came to me later.
I'm not hungry.
I'd rather tell you the truth.
I'd rather you didn't.
You know George? George and my son? You remember?
Yes, I remember. Vaguely, only vaguely. If you could refresh my memory.
You're teasing me. I made up George and my son. Did you hear what I said?
I'm not sure.
I made up George and my son.
You should have told me that next year. You could have told me at Christmas. Been something to look forward to.
How can you look forward to something you don't know is coming?
Oh, I know. I knew everything was coming sooner or later in some time. I was in no hurry. I have perhaps 5 years left. It would have filled up the years.
You're talking strangely.
It's been forced on me. What a beautiful.
It's a part of you.
How did you know it was my favorite color? It's very beautiful. It's very feminine.
Oh, it's not really for me. It belonged to my sister, my younger sister.
You never mentioned your younger sister.
You never asked me.
It was intentional.
You've never told me anything about yourself.
Where you work?
It's as I said, I'm unemployed.
Yes, but before?
I worked for the government for a number of years, a clerk. And before that?
I was at school. It's not been very interesting. There have been few interesting things. Rather boring, in fact. What I have had, I've eked out. I've made it last, if you understand me. Made by few pleasures. I once made love to a lady of my acquaintance for 32 hours. She was often asleep. The pity of it was only 32 hours, because after that I had to go home and I had nothing left to do. I had nothing for years after that. should be possible to do better than 32 pounds.
We can do better than that.
I know. But I had wished it for later. I had wished to save it up for several Christmases from now.
It seems silly to wait.
Excuse me.